My name is Jacob Colgrove. I'm Assistant Product Manager here at Redline Controls. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to connect the RAM 9000 Cellular RTU to the Telenor Connection IoT platform using the RAM QTT client driver. First, I'll show you how to configure Telenor to accept incoming connections. Then I'll show you how to configure the RAM 9000 to initiate a secure encrypted connection to Telenor. So let's start off by configuring a thing in the Telenor Connection IoT platform.
Go to the Telenor website with your login. So we're going to start off by creating a thing type. You'll see that on the left-hand side. A thing type is a group of things or devices. And this gives you a way to organize products by function or location so that you can manage all those devices together. So assign a label for the thing type. In this case, I'll type in RAM 9000. Then assign a description for the thing, and this is more detail on the function or the location. Assign a domain, which is assigned by Telenor when you create your account. In this case, we have Red Lion as our domain. When you successfully create the thing type, you'll see it on the left-hand side. Select that thing type, and then your main display window will change. It will show you all the things listed in that thing type. It'll default to the overview, which will filter all your devices and show where they're located if you have GPS data going to the Telenor device. But we'll go to the list view to show a list of all the things that we have in this thing type group. Click on the Add Thing button to add a thing or device to our thing type. Here we need to assign the number of things to add. Enter the domain assigned to you by Telenor. In this case, we'll select Red Lion. Once you successfully created your thing, the thing or things will show up in your list. Please take note of the thing ID that's listed there because we're going to use that later in our RAM configuration. Also, you'll notice that the icons for our things indicate that the RAM is not connected. You can see the cloud that's crossed out there. After the thing or things are created, we need to download our security keys so that our RAM can connect. And these will be downloaded to the RAM eventually, so we need to download them from the Telenor Cloud Connect website and then place them in a place that we can find later on so that we can load them into our RAM 9000. And these security certificates allow us to create a secure encrypted connection to the Telenor Cloud Connect. These are X.509 certs that provide keys for a secure encrypted web communication from the RAM 9000 to the Telenor Cloud Connect. These security certificates and keys are more secure than username and passwords because they stay on the device and nobody needs to use them after they're loaded onto the device. So check the checkbox for the thing, then click on the dialog button and click on Download Certificate. This will download a zipped file of all the security keys that will be used and loaded onto the device later on. So extract these security keys onto your computer so that you can find them later when we're configuring the RAM 9000. Remember, no spaces can exist in the file names of these devices.
Now I'll show you how to configure the RAM 9000 so that it can initiate that secure encrypted connection to Telenor.
To configure our RAM 9000, we'll go to the RAM 9000 web server, go to Services, then go to RAM QTT Client. To enable the RAM QTT Client driver, select Yes in the Enable RAM QTT Client option. For the IoT Cloud, select Telenor Cloud Connect. For the broker, we'll enter the broker address supplied to us by Telenor. So this will be unique per account. For the port, we'll type in 8883. This is the RAM QTT secure port. For device name, we'll enter the device ID that was supplied to us when we created our thing in the Telenor Cloud Connect. So I'll paste that in here. For the minimum publish interval, we'll set 5 seconds. The RAM QTT client driver will only send data to the Telenor Cloud Connect when values are changing. But this setting here is useful when values are changing relatively quickly and you don't need to see the granularity within the RAM QTT Cloud Connect. So this interval will limit the amount of messages that are sent out to the Cloud Connect when the values are changing very frequently. For the sake of this test, I'm selecting 5 seconds, but the number would normally be higher than this to save on data usage. But it depends on the requirements of the application. The device info message setting is a pre-packaged set of RAM-specific information like serial number, firmware version, model number. This way, you can have that information available right on the Telenor dashboard. Select none here if you don't want to send any RAM-specific information. And you just want to send the IO information. Select basic if you want to send a limited set of information like unit name, serial number, cell IP, uptime, version, model number. Select the full to send the basic information plus the power input voltage, full cellular information, and full GPS information if you have GPS connected. We'll select basic here for this test. The device info publish interval is how often the device information will get resent to the cloud. So we'll leave it at the default 480 minutes because this information doesn't need to get sent to the cloud very often. The keep alive is the minimum amount of time that the connection will be left idle. The values don't change for a long period of time, then this keep alive will send a keep alive ping in order to keep the connection active. But for this test, we'll leave it at default. The track errors setting sets whether an error message would be sent to the cloud or not. In this case, we're going to set no. For the device cert, we're going to find the cert.pem that was downloaded earlier from the Telenor site. Then for the device cert key, we're going to find the priv key or P-R-I-V key.pem that was downloaded earlier and extracted from the zipped set of certificates. Then for our device root CA, we're going to find the root CA.pem that's supplied to us by Telenor when we create our account. Now we'll add the IO register data that we want to send to the cloud. In this case, I'm going to add multiple IO points. The first that I'll select here is the DI1 register because I have a switch connected to it. It allows me to turn it on and off so that I can see the values changing within the Telenor Cloud Connect. The next thing I'll do is use the filter to find the time seconds variable, which will show the seconds of the clock, and this will allow me to see the minimum publish interval of 5 seconds that we configured because the clock will be updating every second. Now we can test the connection with the Telenor Cloud Connect by clicking the test server availability button. Once the RAM tells us that our communication is successful, then we can click the apply button to commit the changes to the RAM 9000. Click on the show status button to show the communication status. When we're in that window, we'll need to refresh to get the information. Then you'll see the communication status there, the data sent, and the last message sent, which will show up in the Telenor Cloud Connect. Now we'll go back to the Telenor Cloud Connect to see what it looks like when the RAM connects and sends its data. So go to your Cloud Connect portal. We'll click on the RAM 9000 thing type that we created earlier. And then in our list, we'll see the one thing that we added earlier. We can click on our device. And once we click on our device, it'll give us a summary page, the thing summary page. And notice on the right hand side, we'll see that the cloud icon is no longer grayed out and crossed out, but it's green, indicating that we've sent data. The no service message there indicates the cell service that's being used to connect to our Telenor Cloud Connect. Since this demo, I'm connecting through a wired cell router, the no service indicated there is saying that I'm not using any cell service. If you were connecting through cell service, you'd see something like LTE or 3G. Notice that the map window would show the location of your thing too if you had a GPS connection to your RAM 9000. Click on the information drop-down list and select device info to see the information sent from the device info message from the RAM. Click on the information drop-down list. Now select IODB registers or IODB. And these are all the IO points that we've configured in the RAM 9000 to send to the Telenor Cloud Connect. IODB refers to all the IO that exist in the RAM 9000. Notice the time underscore seconds is updating every 5 seconds. And that goes along with the minimum publish interval. When I turn on the DI1 with my switch here, then you can see that a 1 shows up. You can change the way the data is displayed by adding a widget. So to do that, click on the Add Widget button at the top right hand corner. In this case, I'll add a gauge for the time underscore seconds IO point that I have. The label will be time underscore gauge. The widget type is gauge. The resource is the IODB register from the RAM 9000, the time underscore seconds. And since we're visualizing seconds, the minimum of the gauge will be 0 and the maximum will be 60. Now, it's not a settable widget, which indicates that it's not a value that I can send back to the RAM. Instead, it's something that we're observing coming from the RAM 9000 device. Then we'll click Done. And you'll notice that the gauge will slowly increase by 5 seconds until it gets to 60, then it will go back to 0.
So as you can see, connecting the RAM 9000 Cellular RTU to the Telenor Connection IoT platform using the RAM QTT client driver is easy. For more information and tutorials, please go to www.redlion.net.